This will be the app portion for the Wyze Light Strip Pro. Here you can see the main Wyze screen when you first log in to your Wyze app. Over here you will see that I have other Wyze products, but at the top here I have my Light Strip Pro. You have a simple on-off button. Toggling this will change the color and let you know that you have turned on and off your light strip. Selecting the actual light strip area for will bring you into the actual settings area for the light strip. Here at the top, you can see I have my light strip and then a plus symbol. Both of my light strips connected, and then I can actually use this right here in order to create a group. Now, I don't have both of them connected at this time, so I only have the one, but you do see right here, it does indicate what it is. Here, there's a little picture, which might be a little hard to see, but if I toggle this right here, which is an on-off button with a light slider, so brighter, less light, this icon right here lights up. And you'll notice it might be a little tricky to see, but there is a little music sign next to that. If I select this light strip, you can see that you can, if you press and hold on your light strip, you can see that you actually have segments. And what this is, it's a little kind of snake thing. So you can select specific areas that you would want to light up and then close. And what that'll do is that is just going to affect those targeted areas. Now, if you tap it on and off like I did, that's going to target everything. And I'll show you a little later what that looks like on the actual light strip itself. Most of the stuff on this screen is better shown with the light strip. So why don't I pause the tabletop portion to show you what all of this looks like with the light strip. We're gonna start on the design wheel here. This is a color wheel that you can select any color on the wheel that you want. There's lots of in-between colors, which is really great. The one thing I wish they would do is allow you to click and drag the color wheel like they do with their Wyze bulbs. I would love to be able to drag the wheel to a different color. But you can see right here, as I showed before, brightness increasing, brightness decreasing, and when you get to about 1%, some of these other modes will turn off. Quick toggle on and off right there. On and off. You could see that as I've been changing the color on the color wheel, the actual LED strip icon also changes, which is kind of cool. If we scroll down, we have our swatches, which are, you know, the color swatches for this area. We can select edit and change any of our swatches that we don't like. What we're going to do now is I'm going to swipe it over because here's our warm, bright, you know, this is our normal Kelvin style light wheel. What we're gonna do now is come over to scene, and just like our scene with the Wyze color bulbs, the more light strips that you have, the more color variants that you'll get. So I was setting up one for Christmas, and you'll notice that it's not here because I don't have enough light strips in order to do this. But you do have color scenes down here: energize, gaming, movie night, and then different colors right there. The more interesting one is right here, which is music. And right here you could see I set up for the festive holidays with red and green right there, and this is shadow, and it will show you sensitivity, low to high. It also has auto coloring down here in the bottom, which is why it's selecting just those two colors as opposed to a bunch of other colors. If I show you what I did for auto color, I just selected two colors. Now, right now it's just staying on green, but we're gonna slap that back on to have my red green motif. We're gonna show you what lens looks like. So we're gonna bring that over, let it load. That's what lens looks like as far as a color change goes based on my voice. That's actually leap, my apologies. You have options for each of these. Whole, which would be the whole light strip. As you see, it's changing the color of the whole light strip, as opposed to circulation, which is gonna do portions of the light strip. And again, sensitivity right up there. We're gonna come over to flicker. I wish they'd let you drag it, but they make you click on it. And here we got whole, subsections, and circulation. So if I change that to circulation, that's what that looks like. I'm gonna bring it up to subsections, which is what that looks like. And then whole once again, just to give you an idea. And keep in mind, these are the colors that I put in place. We're gonna come over to marquee, right there, marquee. So as you see, look at that. We're talking, marquee is moving, and it's kind of swimming along there, and that's gathered. If we did straight, this is what straight would look like. Notice it changed the color, And I do have the sensitivity set to high. And we're gonna do depressive now. So what does that look like? Well, here we go. It's actually going in the opposite direction and colors are changing a little more. And my cat just kind of came into frame because he is very interested now. We're gonna do color focus next, which is right there, color focus. There you go, you have color focus. It's got a little dancing to it, as you can see right there. But as I talk, it brightens all that up. And that is with gathered. If I did straight, this is what straight would look like. And this is our last option for this. Next, we're gonna come over to water, right there, water. Here's what water would look like. Notice it progressively moves as I speak along the LED light strip. That's gathered. If we do straight, here we go, straight. Similar, but notice the color is slightly changing as it moves along now. And we're gonna do our last option right here. Test, test, one, two, test, test, three, four. Notice it's moving in the opposite direction. We're gonna come over to sea wave, and here we go, sea wave. Notice as I talk, depending on the sensitivity, is how far it goes. So if I lower the sensitivity, you'll notice that I have to speak a little more loudly in order for that to get picked up. We're gonna bring that all the way over. And you kinda get an idea of what the options right here are. So we're just gonna skip over those and move over to shooting star. And here is our shooting star. So it kinda gives you a nice idea of what shooting star is. We're gonna move over to starlight, which is our last option in the app right here. Starlight is a twinkling of color along the LED strip. So starlight looks like this. And notice the color changes as it goes along. What I had it on originally for the purposes of my Christmas usage was this one right here because I kind of liked having the red and green on opposite sides. Now, what I'm going to do is pop back over, put that to red, and then I'm gonna press and hold on my LED strip here to show you that if I start changing specific areas, that this is one way that you'd be able to change the color. So hypothetically, I want this, this, and that one to be green. Press and hold, and you could see that I've got blue, I've got red, I've got green, and I've got a light strip behind me that allows me to have all of those multiple color areas, which is really nice and why you would like to use the Wyze app to do this, because LED Strip Pro lets you have multiple colors along the same LED strip. This is actually something I didn't figure out until much later. So press and hold, and that will give you access to pick the particular quadrants that you want to have your colors with. Coming back to the upper right hand corner here, if we select this, this is actually our settings menu for the light strip itself. Up here you have your device name. You can change that to whatever you'd like. We're gonna hit cancel because I just have that as light strip 2 or light strip 1. Right here you have your device icon giving you an idea of what things that you can use your light strip for. Under a computer, TV set, behind TV, couch, bed, you know, there's a lot of things that you can do with this. We're just gonna leave it at what it is. You have a sleep routine. So you have a wake up routine and a bedtime routine. What that will do is gradually, if you select the wake up routine, gradually increase the color to a brightness that will wake you up. And then you have duration, time set, days of the week, lots of functionality here. And then you have bedtime, so if you wanna dim the lights as you're going to bed, same principle, duration, time, and then days of the week. And then there's no how bright you want to get it because it's going to be dimming the lights no matter what you have them set at. I'm not going to set that. We're going to come back to our scenes, and I set up one particular scene. This is an Xmas scene. Now the scene itself, if I select update, you can change the name here, and that's kind of it because over here, this is the scene. If I want to delete this scene, I come over and I hit that red line, red circle with the line, and that will get rid of the scene. You have your timer. So timer, you can select timer on, how long for it to turn on, and then timer off, same principle, how long until it turns itself off. Vacation mode, this will turn on and off the LED strip at a random pattern to kind of make it seem like somebody's actually home. Sun match. If we select sun match, what this will do is change the color hue of the light bulbs to match the outdoor lighting. So you'll get a warmer light in the evenings and a brighter white light when the sun is out. We're gonna turn that off. Here's one that I am grateful that they have, that Wyze has included even with the LED strip itself, which is power loss recovery. If power is lost to the LED strip, what happens when it turns back on? When power is restored. If you have your Wyze LED light strip on and the power is lost, and then you get power restored at 3 o'clock in the morning, most other companies, that light strip will just come on. Here, you have maintain previous state. So if that light strip is on, it'll come back on. But if that light strip was off, then at 3 o'clock in the morning, that light strip will return to an off state. This is a great feature, and one of the things that I'm happy Wyze added even in this. Here you have your area to select rules, which would be setting up specific rules. So if you have other Wyze products, you can set it up where your Wyze Cam version 3 see somebody come into frame, all your LEDs turn on, and you can select a color. Sharing, this is if you want to share that device with a person, they will need their own Wyze account, and then you just select share user, you put in their user information. Device info, just like it sounds, is going to give you all the information about the Wyze LED strip, and then Wyze support, again, is built in, and then down here we have delete device, so if you want to get rid of your Wyze LED strip, this is how you'd be able to do it. This has been a look at the LED strip portion of the Wyze app.